One of the features of ProcessBook's displays are the ability to incorporate static shapes to complement or give context to some of the dynamic symbols and dynamic elements that you put on your screen. And generally, the static shapes fall into one of three categories. We have your basic shapes, which are things like simple rectangles, circles, lines, chunks of text. Anything that is basic and static would fall into that category, and we'll look at those in a few moments. And then we have something called the symbol library, and the symbol library is a library of graphics that we have licensed from a company that produces these type of things. And this symbol library contains pre-canned graphics that pertain to many of the industries that use our ProcessBook product. So if you have to draw something like a conveyor or a pipe or a certain type of machine, it may already be in our symbol library and you won't have to complete all the elements to it. And then finally, if there's nothing that you want to draw with the basic shapes or you can't find an element in the symbol library, you can always import an image file as long as it's one of the many formats that we support. So you can bring in almost any type of graphic into ProcessBook, and all of these graphics can be grouped, colored, connected. You can do a lot of things with them once you get them into ProcessBook. And we're going to spend a few minutes looking at the various static shapes that are associated with the application. I'm going to start out the basic shapes discussion by creating a new display within my workbook, and I'll call this graphics, and I'll make this a level 2 so it's included on our page 1. And you can see that a new display opens up and it is titled graphics. And what I'm going to do is go to the draw menu and show you that the top of the draw menu is primarily concerned with these two basic type of graphics. I'll select the rectangle to begin with. You'll notice that my cursor changes. I will draw a square and that will be a rectangle. You can also do this from the toolbar by selecting rectangle and drawing a rectangle. And you can see that once you've drawn them, you can move them, resize them, bring them around the board, around the display board, and add items to it. Same way with circles. You can create circles of any size and orientation. You can make flat circles. Now you may notice that every time I'm drawing a circle, it's coming out as a green circle with a black outline. And this is controlled by the default color scheme for ProcessBook. And the default color scheme is set by essentially selecting nothing on the screen, clicking out in the open area, and then selecting Edit, Format, and Color. And this will allow you to set the default colors for things that you draw. You can see I've got a black line is the default. The fill that I have is a dark green, and the background is none. If I change this to make the line a white line with blue filling, that will allow me to create those type of objects. So you can see that every time I draw something now, it's got a white line with blue filling. If you want to change the colors of just one element, you simply click on that element and use the same menu selections, Edit, Format, Color, and you can change the color or style of that. Now all of these items can be grouped and arranged. So for example, if I want to group my green rectangle and my yellow circle, I go into the Arrange menu and select both of them using the control click method, Arrange and Group, and that allows me to group these, and they are now grouped. To ungroup them, simply select Arrange and Ungroup. I can change the order of these items by selecting the one that appears to be drawn in back and selecting Arrange and Bring to Front, and that will change the order. So you can see that there's a lot of different things that you can do with these static shapes.